Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of the Overwhelm Podcast. Before this episode starts, I do just want to say in this episode there are some music, and I do not own anything, alright? I don't own any of this music that's in this episode. All rights reserved to all the original artists. And there's no hate intended for anyone in this episode. It's just my opinions. No hate to all the people I talk about. And hope you guys enjoy.
I'm so caught up in the news of who likes me and who hates you. And I'm so tired that I might quit my job, start a new life. And they'd all be so disappointed, cause who am I if not exploited? Brutal out here. I feel like no one wants me, and I hate the way I'm perceived. I only have two real friends, and lately I'm a nervous wreck. Cause I love people I don't like, and I hate every song I write. And I'm not cool, and I'm not smart, and I can't even parallel park. All I did was try my best. Here.
That was Brutal by Olivia Rodrigo, and Brutal is a really good song, I think. It's one of the not really talked about songs on Sour album, I think, by Olivia. But I think it's up there. But Brutal just got a music video on August 23rd, about a week ago, I believe. Right now, as of recording this, it is, they're just about to go up to 16 million views, and it's on number 17 for trending on, for music. Don't know why I'm getting all these texts, I'm sorry. This is the second time I tried recording this because of my phone blowing up. So that was, Brutal, what you just heard. It's probably right now. And this video is, like, yes, it's really good, but I think it's a little bit weird. I want to say it's a little bit weird. Cause at the beginning, it's like, all, like, I guess, video game style. From, like, 1980. But I'm watching it right now. Again. And I don't know. I know. It's really high production. I know that. It looks really good. So I don't know why she only has 7.50 million subscribers on YouTube. Anyway. the like-to-dislike ratio is 1.2 million. People liked it, then 29,000 people did not like it. About. So, I would say I like it, but I just think it's a little bit weird. Just look for yourself and tell me what you think, because, like, I would say this is her style, and, like, with Good For You, it was kind of like this, a little bit, but Deja Vu is a different song and different style, so I would assume that's a different video, but I would just say that if this would be a little bit different, like a little bit of not so weird. I don't know what I'm saying. All right, I'm just talking. So all of the comments on this are like, this one says the visuals, the choreography, the artistry, the beauty. This woman is a whole package. I'm so glad she's back in it again. Yeah, she actually teased the Brutal music video on Instagram, I believe. And I think I saw a video that she posted a picture of, I think it was a skateboard. It said Brutal on the bottom of it. I think that cued everyone. Yeah, she's making another video. Like, she's poured so much time and energy into this album. I want to know when the next one's coming. Because, where is it? So, this album was, oh, is this year? How did I not know that? Alright, it was this year. But I want to know when another album's coming. I can't wait for that. I really don't know what that's ever going to be about. I'm getting way ahead of myself. I don't know why I'm going all the way out there. Now, the Weeknd is, I guess, not going to be submitting his music for the Grammys. I really don't know why. He has had so much success the past year, and with the other collaborations and his overall fame. I got this from an article. I don't know. I don't remember what it was from, but I know that it said that he was not going to be submitting any of his music for the Grammys. It was really sad. It was like, I would want, I would want my music, if I made some, to be there, to like, that would just give you more publicity. And, what? Oh. Okay, never mind. That's not what I thought it was. He had the collaboration with Ariana Grande, which made records, broke records. Like, I think it was best collaboration. And I need to do this. Then all his new album. Not new, but his album, and then like everything just all coming up, and then his album all last year, not new at all, sorry. But After Hours, and was his other album before After Hours, was that, it was Starboy. Right? No, it wasn't. It was My Dear Melancholy. What? Anyway. So that was in 2018. So he's been going off and on music industry. I think he's seen it for good now. Unless he drops out some for some reason. Excuse me, Jesus. So I don't know what's up with that. But I think it was for, I think it was protest. Don't know what for though. But all I know is that he's not going to be submitting any of his music for the Grammys, and I think you can vote for the MMAs or I don't know what it is really. I don't really look at that stuff. I just voted for Ariana, for all of them. But I think you can vote for your favorite singer or album or whatever. Don't know if it's VMAs, MMAs, or don't know what with all these MMAs or whatever. So I don't know what it is, like I just said, but you can go and try to find that out yourself. Because I don't want to. Sorry. Now, I know you guys are tired of me talking about Ariana Grande, but this needs to be talked about. So, about a month ago, she released all of the rest of her VEMO, I guess, live performances. So now, in total, she made, where is it? She had POV, Safety Net featuring Ty Dolla $ign, My Hair, 34-35, and Off the Table, and then Positions. Don't know if that's in order, but it looks like it is. I think all of them is so good, but like My Hair, I'll play a clip of it right now. The end of My Hair. This is not gonna be the live version, but go watch the live version because it's amazing. Live performance, I guess. The end of My Hair, the originals that she makes are amazing. Here they are. That control, I can't. Oh my god, it's amazing. Like the first time I heard that, I was in disbelief. Like, I know some people don't like whistle notes that much, but like, I have to admit, that control of her voice, and the way she did the, I think is just amazing. And I know like Mariah Carey and all the other singers can do it, but like the high was a note with that. Jeez. I just love it. Anyway, in the Positions VEMO performance, in the beginning she did a live like production thing with a mixer. Go watch it yourself. I cannot put it in this episode or a podcast in general. I don't know why. I have not figured that out yet. I'm sorry. But go watch that. It's right in the beginning. It's amazing. I think now she's starting to get like, she's trying to get more into the producer and producing, that's what producer is, like the producing side of things, and I want to see more of that. I think it's really cool. I just can't wait for what she brings next. And speaking of bringing something next, she on April 1st, and like, that was a long time ago, but I haven't been able to get this since a few weeks ago. So Ariana just dropped the God's a Woman perfume, and I just got it like a few weeks ago, and it is amazing. Like, I have it right here, and it smells way more like don't know how to put this, but it smells way more like adult than what she usually does. And, you know, Guy's a Woman is an amazing song from her. And, you know what, I'll just play it right now. I'll just play a little bit of it. It lingers when we're done. You believe God is a woman. I tell you all the things you should know. So baby, take my hand, save your soul. We can make it last, take it slow. And I can tell that you know I know how I want it, yeah. That you're different from the rest. And boy, if you confess, you might get blessed. I think it is an amazing song, and I listen to it at least every single day. Once every single day, at least. So, I love this perfume. I love the model, too. Like, it comes in this 3D, not of course 3D, but like, I don't know how to explain it. You have to look it up. It's like, I put a picture of it up, on YouTube. If you guys listen to this on YouTube, I put a picture up on YouTube. Of course, it has the copyright thing. Not copyright. The thing through the middle of the all the videos for some reason. So go look this up and look this and buy it if you want to. Like, it smells amazing. It smells like fruity and like, I don't know, it's like more adult than what she usually has. Like, I have the Sweet Like Candy, Moonlight, Thank You Next, and Now God's a Woman. And I have the Ari, Thank You Next, Sweet Like Candy, and Cloud Body Mist. So from all ones that I smelled before, and I have, this one, I don't know, it just smells more fruitier and, like, more adult than with the other ones that she has. Also, the box is different. Like, it's much more, like, it's not what she usually does with, like, the little, the circle ones. It's like rectangle and it looks amazing. So, got the box right here, and it feels different. And first of all, the image on here is amazing. So this says, we are committed to making our packaging friendlier to the planet by using suitable materials and responsibility sourced ingredients. I cannot speak. You will continue to see exciting changes over time across all of our fragrances. Thank you for taking this journey with us. It says the same thing in Spanish, I think. So, good job, Ariana. You're doing good for the planet and good for yourself. I love it so much. I got the largest one, which is, what one is this? Does it say on here? I think I get the largest one. Here it is. It's 3.4 fluid ounces. This is the biggest one. It was, right now I think it's only at Ulta Beauty. But I think it was around $70, which I don't really like, but you know, all the other ones I had were, I think like $33, maybe, if I got all those at Walgreens. This is only at Ulta Beauty. And I love it. It's like, I wish I could show this to you. But, yeah, I put a picture up. I think it looks amazing. And I just love everything about it. 10 out of 10 would recommend this to anyone. I want to talk about the Fish Girl from Cut. You might have seen it Probably 99% of you guys have seen it. Because she has been all over the whole entire internet. Just exploding. Because a few years ago, I know that she was 14 at the time. Let's see. How old was she? That came out a year ago. So her name is Jaden, and I think she's 17 right now. So anyway, she has been blowing up on TikTok, YouTube, everywhere. And I don't know how I feel. Like, at first it was funny, but now, one is starting to get old. It's really old. And it just came back for another lap. And, like, she's on an interview with, what's it called? With the Undecided Gen Z, the podcast. Shout out to them. And she talks about just getting punched, like, for no reason. Like, she was mean. She did admit that. And I just think the whole entire internet need to take a step back and look at, hey, this is a kid. Why are we being mean to her? Like, it just makes no sense to me. Because, I'm looking at YouTube right now. I see, all I gotta put is marine biologist girl. I got, how much is this? Don't know how much it is. There's pages and pages full of it. Oh my god. And they're all saying that this teen is so toxic. And worst girl ever. And people are doing it in Roblox, which I think is just dumb. Yeah. She really got popular by the meme where she said Nina, Nina, Nina. If you guys want to go look at the original video, that's from YouTube channel Cut. It has 10 million views so far. Uploaded a year ago, and it's called 7 High Schoolers Decide Who Wins $1,000. 1,000 to 1 cut. So, like, this one says, first girl annoying everyone for 2 minutes straight. But, like, I don't get it. Because all of these people are just making fun of her over and over again. And it's supposed to be the next thing, too. It's just ridiculous. I forget what I want to say with this, also. I just think that we need to look at the new stuff. Oh, here it is. I think Jordan thinks that she said that they edited the video to, like, a way that she didn't really think that was appropriate. I'm sorry, I don't know her pronouns. I think they're she or. I'm sorry if there aren't. But, yeah. Everyone's blasting her. And I just think it's ridiculous. Because if you were put in this situation where you had to try to get out 14 other kids for $1,000, like, $1,000 is a lot of money. To a teen. Like, you can buy so much stuff for that. Stuff that would come out with that, like, would be pretty heavy. Because, like, if you wanted the money, and then, like, stuff would go and, like, it would come out, I don't know what I'm saying, but it would come out, and it will actually show itself for what it is. And when people blast you for doing something that you did over a year ago, and totally different person now, I just think it's really bad and, like, awkward. It's like, I don't know what to say. So, that's that. And Jordan, if you're listening to this somehow, hope you're doing well. And, yeah. Now, next topic. Jojo Siwa. No, you guys probably heard of her. You think that she's really annoying and this and that, but actually, just listen to me. Listen to me. So, I guess Jojo is going to be the first female dancer on Dancing with the Stars to dance with another female or a person with the same sex. So, you know, that's really nice for that company, the Dancing with the Stars thing. I don't really watch Dancing with the Stars, like, at all. But, you know, it's pretty cool. I can't believe she's going to be the first one, though. Like, shouldn't this be, like, already done, like, a long time ago? Anyway, congratulations, JoJo. And I just think that, Dancing with the Stars could have done something a little bit earlier. No hate to you, JoJo, but I just, like, the company's fault. Anyway, I'm looking at the downside. I'm so happy for you, and hope you get more chances like this, and I hope that more companies do this and make it a regular, because it's annoying that when it's not, you know? I want to talk about this up-and-coming, I guess you could say, people saying Grammy winner. I wouldn't say Grammy winner, but, you know, that's, I'll let you guys decide. This is, okay, yeah, I'll say it like this. I'm trying not to be mean. His name is Gavin Magnus. You probably don't know him, because he's a teenager, but he's a rapper as well. His songs are, they're sometimes good. Like, his newest song called Ice, that's really good. But he's changed a lot. Like, he's gone from little baby, like, singing about catch feelings, to singing songs about when you're horny. So, yeah, that's, you know, go listen to his new song, Ice, on all streaming platforms if you want to. This is a little bit of his older song called Hearts Independent. Hearts Independent is okay for what it is. I think one of his better songs, like, his voice has matured a lot. But this is Hearts Independent with Gavin Magnus featuring Jam Jr., which I'm assuming was his producer. So here it is. She breaks hearts, leaving hearts on the floor. She breaking hearts, leaving hearts on the pendant. Suicide doors and bow, and I ain't running. Left me in the dark, still winning. I pray for you, yet you're still sinning. Party with the demons, is it worth it while you're living? Remember all the times that we've been sharing, now you're missing. Tired of being alone, I admit it. Feeling broken inside, you can't fix it. Take what you want, cause I'm gonna give it a take. What you want, cause now I'm giving it all. Wake me up when everybody is gone. Wake me up when you get ready to go.
mountain roller coaster, we go up and down. Saying that you love me, but baby, I know you'll tear me down. We're running in circles, finding answers, I think we need to know. Cause we're moving way too fast, need to slow it down.
So, yeah, that is that. But yeah, I think he's overall good kid, I guess you could say. But he changed a lot. But he also does have a YouTube channel that he posts all the music on, of course. But he does, like, these, I don't know how to say it, I guess challenges slash vlogs, I guess. So his YouTube is Gavin Magnus. Go check him out. And, yeah, he's, I only watch him for the music, but, you know, he's pretty good. Thank you so much for listening to this episode of the Overwhelmed Podcast. If you do want to support me more, you can drop a follow. If you're on anything else, if you're on YouTube, then you can subscribe and like the video. And turn the bell notifications on. Make sure it's on always instead of, like, most of the time. And thank you for watching and listening. And to see you guys next episode, which I don't know when. So, bye.